1, 2, 3, 4.
Sister, sister, have you heard? I know a word that's a magic word. Just make a wish and say kikanaloo. Kikanaloo.
Sasma show a certain respect for fathers, my boy, whether they like it or not. Hello, Captain. Captain Hanson, Giovanni Borghese. May I introduce to you my son, Leon Cavallo? Isn't you every inch a captain, my boy?
This is the captain.
Hello, Captain.
Buongiorno, buongiorno.
Thank you. The ship is beautiful, isn't it, Leon Cavallo?
Rome is beautiful.
Captain Hanson?
Yes?
I am the diver, Toshi.
Ah, yes. Ohayo gotaima. Where are the others?
They're here. With your permission, we would like to bless your ship and all those on her.
I would be honored. All right, gentlemen, that's enough now. Back to work.
There she is, Captain. A veritable gem.
One moment, please. Get the steam up. It won't be long now.
Yes, sir.
What?
A veritable gem, don't you think?
Oh, yes.
You will be careful with the loading, won't you?
We'll take care of it. You built that yourself?
Yes. Plus the very expensive help of 50 natives.
A beautiful monstrosity. Butterfly 3. You think it'll work?
Well, I think I've corrected what sunk the first two.
Oh, really?
All that money put into my marine experiments. Whew. I was rich once, you know. No, I mean really rich. Do you think it'll work?
It better. Hey, David. Aren't those people on the wrong dock?
I'm afraid not, Chris. They are passengers. 30 of them, bound for the island of Madura.
Passengers? 30? I'm not going to Madura.
There's no other ship sailing as close as you are.
Just wait a moment, will you?
You persist, I take it, in sailing into the mouth of a raging volcano.
Krakatoa is hardly a raging volcano. It has been quiet for 200 years. Look, just get those prisoners away from my ship, will you?
I've been authorized to offer you £2 a head.
I'm sorry. We are not equipped to carry convicts.
Now, Chris, don't explode! £4 a head, Chris. Now, what do you make of that?
It's no good, I tell you.
Come on, sign on the form.
I have no room. Where shall I put them?
Put them in the hold, of course.
In the hold? In this heat? They won't be climbing up the bulkhead.
They won't climb very far with chains, poor devils.
And I have no food. They cannot eat the chains.
The rations are over there on the quay waiting to be loaded. Chris, there's no question about this. It's government business, unless you decide not to sail and have your ship impounded.
Why don't you get your jam rigged for loading? Send them aboard.
Up here! On deck!
Get on!
So this is the Batavia Queen. Why do they call this Batavia?
What?
The boat. Why do they call it the Batavia Queen?
Oh, because it was originally her home port. Batavia. Batavia. Java.
That's nice. I never thought of a thing like that. A boat having a home or anything. Are you Mr. Hanson?
That's right, I'm Mr. Hans.
Here, just one minute. I'm Charlie. Social occasions, weddings, and smokers.
And soprano. You sing.
Hanson.
Yes.
I'm Harry Connerly.
Yes, I know.
He's the best underwater man there is.
I'm sure he is.
Now, this is a salvage job, is it?
That's right.
How deep do we go?
Well, according to the chart, if it's where we think it is, it's about 18 fathoms.
18, 48, take away 4.
Yeah, that's 108 feet.
We work on straight shares?
That's right, it's a gamble.
What's the division?
Fifth.
How about a little money in advance, then?
No, no. We share and share alike.
I don't know about that. Listen, Captain. What if I say no? You got another man ready?
Well, I always could put on a suit myself and go down. But I'm sure you'd do the better job.
That's right. I can't get any money in advance.
No, you can't. Sorry.
How many of these convicts you got aboard?
30.
30? Now, I know the government pays between £2 and £4 each. I kind of think you got 4.
That's right.
Then you give me 60. That's half.
Are you that broke?
I am.
All right. For the courtesy of the government.
Take it over to a boat.
Look what I found on the dock. heard about Krakatoa?
Yes, I heard about it.
Are the others here yet?
Yes, come.
Look out!
Hello, Lester.
Cap?
So, you finally made it, hmm? How did it happen?
Oh, card game. I, killed a man. Salvage. Dora?
Eventually.
Dang. Who's new chief in the engine room?
Driscoll. Good man. Very good man. He improved a lot. Yu Su Chi. Anything I can do for you while you're on board?
Let me stay on deck, Cap. Breathe fresh air. Eat by myself. That's a zoo down there.
Will you behave? All right.
Now, what did you give him that dumb card for, huh? Weddings and social occasions, for God's sake.
And smokers.
Oh, and smokers, sure. Charlie, you were so lousy, you put your piano player to sleep.
Maybe. But I know how to keep you awake, Harry. I'm looking for an old-fashioned boy who's looking for an old-fashioned girl. Just a nice old-fashioned girl like me. I want a boy who's happy that I can blush because I'm bashful and shy. Just a nice old-fashioned girl like me.
Borghese's height in his balloon, he naturally has an advantage of seeing into the shallower waters over a wider area.
You will be in the deep water.
What he can't see, you can. I'm using all the tools at my disposal, Mr. Rigby. That's why I've got two kind of divers.
Perlis for mobility, Connolly for depth.
I mean to find that wreck any way I can, as quickly as I can.
Yes, well, I wasn't complaining about your operation of the search. It's really quite ingenious. It's just that the others were saying...
Mr. Rigby, you graduated from college, didn't you?
Yes, from Oxford.
Thank you.
Mr. Jacobs?
I don't know.
South 75 East.
South 75 East.
South 75 East.
Good work, sir.
But you do remember saying goodbye to me in Batavia?
Of course.
What ship did you take back to Anger?
You know what ship.
I do.
Of course you do, the Indies Cloud.
Oh, yes. Was Travis expecting you?
I don't remember. Chris, why are you asking me this?
What did he say?
I just told you, I don't remember.
Well, he must have said something. Had he heard about us?
Chris, it's been too long. I'm too hot and I'm tired and I just don't feel like
talking about it. Well, sooner or later it has to be talked about. At St. Margaret's, you couldn't eat, you couldn't sleep, and you refused to talk. How could they help you under those circumstances?
I didn't ask for help.
But you needed it. Did he know that we were seeing each other?
Yes.
Did he anticipate your asking for a divorce?
I don't remember.
Well, did he say whether
he was abusive? He said a lot of things. Mostly what he was saying was no.
And? Tell me. Tell me.
He said, if I attempted to divorce him, he was going to take my son away. I was never going to see Peter again. Funny, he didn't want the marriage and he didn't want divorce, so we fought.
And?
Nothing.
Go on.
No, that's all.
That's all he
said? That's all I remember.
Did you leave or did he?
I suppose he left.
And then?
And then nothing.
Try.
No!
What was the last, the very last thing he said?
I told you!
That he would take Peter away if you ask for a divorce. And then you said what?
I don't know. I can't think. I don't know.
Well, did you say that?
For God's sake, stop it, Chris.
If you had agreed not to ask for divorce, Peter would still be with you, wouldn't he? And you would still be with Travis. So you didn't agree not to ask for divorce.
Don't keep after me.
Well, then answer. What did you say to him? What did you say to him?
Go to hell! That's what I said! I told him he couldn't hurt me with his threats, that I was coming back to you with or without a divorce. I don't even think I realized what I was saying. He stormed through the house. And after I don't know how long, it was quiet. He'd taken Peter. I'd let him take my boy away. Oh. My feeling for you had distorted everything. Suddenly began to realize that I never was going to see my son again, so I ran to the dock. The Adriana was just leaving the harbor. I let him go, didn't I, Chris? I let him go, didn't I, Chris? Didn't I? Oh, I have no right to a life if Peter's dead.
Laura. Laura, listen to me. Please. I do love you. And I know that inside this pretty head, you and I are guilty. As long as we haven't found Peter. And that's what we have to do. Find him.
Hey, Larry.
Huh?
What do you think of that, then?
I was just enjoying your game. What is it called?
It's Ginikling from the Philippines.
Please, I would love to try it.
Hachimasho.
Hajime Masho.
I'm Leon Cavallo Borghese.
Rion Cavallo?
No. Leon. You know, I like the way you say it better.
You are kind. Let's begin. Hachi.
What is your name?
Toshi.
Toshi. Toshi.
Looks like we're both wearing irons of the sword, aren't we?
Are we?
How long you been working with those busted lungs?
We got enough to do wearing them leg irons without worrying about my insides.
Way I look at it, you're the only one above deck that's in anywhere near as bad shape as I am. Worse, maybe. You know, that laudanum's bad stuff. Anything that loaded with opium. I knew a man once on that stuff. One day picked up an axe, a regular double-bitted axe.
To you.
Oh, I've seen a lot of those little green bottles. So's Hanson. But why? Why are you still working? I've seen divers with better lungs than yours sweeping the streets rather than go down again.
Maybe I got one good shot left.
Well, you sure picked a beaut.
Why?
You could have picked one. Better odds than this.
What do you mean by that? Don't Hanson know what he's doing?
Well, anyway, go light on those little green bottles, eh?
Say something.
My biggest problem, all mouth. Forget it.
Look, I got too much riding on this job. I want to know.
Hanson will throw me right back in that hole.
What the hell were you going to say?
Well, I didn't tell you because I thought it's none of your business.
What do you mean it's none of my business? What do you think I'm here for?
Captain Hanson, I give up a tour of France for this. If Mrs. Travis is not well, if her information, the information we depend on in risking our time and our lives, is doubtful, why, of course it concerns all of us.
She told you there was a fortune in pearls. Now, how can you trust somebody who spent the last year in a mental institution?
So what? She didn't put this trip together, I did. She didn't hire you, I did. We discussed that 3 weeks ago, and nothing has changed.
Well, how do you know she didn't dream it all up when she was out of her head?
Good evening.
Hello. You haven't met these people, have you?
No, I don't believe I have.
Giovanni Borghese, my son.
This is Douglas Rigby, the owner of that beautiful diving bell. This is Miss Toshi. And this is Miss Charlie...
Adams. Social occasions, weddings, and smokers. Remember?
Yes, I do remember. And soprano.
How do you do? How do you do?
And this is Mr. Connolly.
Mrs. Travis? Are there any pearls on your husband's ship?
They're supposed to be. Captain Hanson thinks that there are.
Laura, your husband had a sort of tradition. On each birthday of your son, he gave you a pearl. I know you have them always with you. You mind showing them?
No, no, of course not.
How much is this worth?
It is very valuable. Only twice before in my life have I seen a pearl like this.
And hundreds of them would be...
worth a fortune.
May I see it? Thank you.
This is only one pearl out of the shipment the Adriana was carrying. There are 10 packages more, just a few days from here.
Well, I got no place else to go anyway.
Dinner is supposed to be served at 8, Mr. Connolly. Well, shall we sit down?
Thank you.
If you'll excuse me.
The engines.
Stop all engines!
Jayadapa!
Captain.
Yes?
Well, what do you think?
I think we should go back and finish our dinner.
Full speed ahead.
You scared me. Harry, are you sick?
I hope to hell I'm sick. I wouldn't want to feel like this and be well.
Harry, please. I know you're in pain, but please, go easy on the laudanum.
Charlie, we don't know if there's any pearls down there like that woman says. We don't even know if the wreck's where it's supposed to be. What if we get there, huh? We don't know if I can dive again, do we?
Harry, why don't you tell Hanson?
You tell Hanson nothing. We need that money.
Harry, we don't need the money that much. Suppose you have to go down deep.
If I go deep as I have to. If I can.
Harry.
I don't want to talk about it no more.
You're only hurting yourself.
Get away from me, Charlie.
No. Harry?
Thank you.
Pretty. I wouldn't presume to suggest that I know how you feel. But I sympathize. I think I know a little about people. I played over 200 carnivals. And from the height of my balloon and sometime closer, I've seen them all. Well, people are confusing, aren't they? They put a label on this one or that, but...
Mr. Borghese, labels are for jelly jars. I've been a singer all my life, with my kind of voice, mostly saloons. Anyway, I can tell you firsthand, don't put labels on people. I've seen the nice guys with the shiny faces and white collars pinch bottoms. And I've seen the mean ones, or the ones that look mean pinch bottoms too. So don't tell me about labels. I've seen the one they put on Harry.
People believe him to be a very violent man.
People. Do people know Harry Connolly?
And I'm sure you're right. So now you sit here thinking, remember all kinds of things, that he liked children, that he was very kind to old ladies, perhaps?
To be very honest with you, Mr. Borghese, I wouldn't care if he kicked old ladies in the teeth. He's good to me.
Do you know? In a way, he's a very fortunate man.
Another 4 degrees.
Chris, some more of them.
I have a theory about the heat and everything. Would you like to hear it? Would you like to come in?
Where on earth do you sleep, Mr. Rigby?
Oh, I don't know. Anywhere, on the floor sometimes. I'll get you a seat.
Thank you.
My theory is they're all connected. The heat, the dead fish, the lights on the horizon, the weird sound, the lot. All connected. Look, I'll show you. Here. Oh. Here's Rikiak.
Mm-hmm.
Perket, Malim, and Krakatoa. Some volcanic and some not, but all connected in an underground chain.
Uh-huh. But Krakatoa is the only dangerous one.
Krakatoa is the powder keg, and the whole island chain is the fuse. The heat, for instance, is being generated right underneath us this very moment. Oh, and that banshee shriek that nearly drove us out of our mind. I'll show you, look. That was caused by underground pressure bursting through the Earth's surface somewhere around here. Let me make it easier. It's rather like a boiling kettle. Too small a spout.
Have you told the others your theories, Mr. Rigby?
Oh, no. Might put them off the whole trip.
Why are you telling me this?
I just thought it might help to know that these strange happenings are quite explainable. Mrs. Travis, speaking of fear, are you frightened of heights, closed in places, or anything like that?
No.
No, I just wonder because I am. Claustrophobia. It's ridiculous, isn't it?
And you go down in that steel thing?
Chamber pot? That's what my father used to call it, an old chamber pot. Yes, I go down there. I suppose to fight the fear. And because I'm so fascinated by what I see under the water. That's why I'm here. You see, the valuables in your husband's safe can make my marine experiments possible. And if we are blotted out while trying, well, it won't have been completely pointless. For me, anyway.
Confined in this small bell. Under the circumstances, Mr. Rigby, wouldn't a man have to be the tiniest bit insane to do what you do?
Yes, I suppose he would.
Hartley!
Get him out.
Oh, hello. Welcome to West Purgatory.
Chris, you must bring him down. We've discussed it. Harry Connolly can't survive in this heat.
Just one moment. We have discussed it? Are we ruling this ship by committee
Sorry,
now?
That's not what I meant.
Well, am I permitted to have a vote under these new rules, or half a vote?
Mr. Hanson, he'll be of no help to you if you leave him up there.
I'm not quite sure, Miss Adams, how much more of his help I can afford.
But you don't understand. You don't understand.
We already took him down, Miss Adams. Forgive me. He's waiting for you below.
Can I get you something? Some more water or damp cloth for your head?
What's the matter with you?
Nothing.
Well, you did all right while I was up there, Charlie. You did just fine.
It's okay.
Come on, Charlie. What's wrong with you? One of them say something to you?
No, but I felt funny. Nobody had said anything about anything, but I knew what they thought you had done to that girl. Harry. What do you suppose they think about me?
That never seemed to bother you before.
Once in a while, they forget and start acting like a girl.
And you want to watch your step? One of these days, I'm liable to ruin a good thing and marry you.
You never ever kidded about that before.
I'm kidding now, so don't send out any announcements. Here, the water's getting warm.
Yes, sir.
Reduce speed to a dead slow.
Dead slow.
And take soundings till it clears.
Yes, sir.
Chris, is it Krakatoa again?
We don't know what it is.
By the mark! Six!
It's been like a series of warnings. This smoke is the most frightening of all.
I think we better get Rigby and the Borghese's ready.
Yes, sir.
And shake out the compressor crew.
One!
Krakatoa.
Thank you.
26, 8, 83. Sullivan? It's fantastic down here. Take me up about 5 or 6 fathoms, quickly.
Take it up 5 fathoms, fast.
Nothing down there.
Papa.
Look.
Let me see.
What do you think?
Yes.
That's it?
Of course, we found it. That's it.
Take me 10 degrees to port. Now, easy, easy. Easy. There she is. About 30 odd yards.
It's beautiful. Papa, the propeller.
Hey. Hey, try to crank it.
It's stuck.
Hey, Frank. Look, they're drifting away.
Thank you.
Connerly important in this go-around?
Without Connerly, we couldn't get the safe up.
You're playing out a missed deal, Cap.
What?
I say you're playing out a missed deal. Your diver lied to you. Lungs. They're shot.
I don't like ship talk.
That ain't ship talk, Cap. That's grade A absolute truth.
How do you know?
That business in the chain locker with the Japanese girl? That's laudanum. Ever see a diver spend so much time looking at a depth gauge? Looks like you may have to put on a suit yourself.
Think you're doing?
Well, even you should be able to figure that one.
I signed on here as a diver, and I ain't signed off yet.
Your lungs are gone, right? You take laudanum, right?
Yeah, that's right. I'm still the only diver you got.
Look, you nailed me for advance money because you have a fat reputation. Because I was stuck for a diver. Now you can't deliver. It's all right. I don't need you. I can do it myself.
I can get down there and I can get back up again. Now what happens after that's up to me.
Captain!
Take over while I'm below.
Yes.
If anything happens...
Captain! The diving bell's jammed on the coral. It's got his air hose.
Make sure there's enough slack on the cable.
Right, sir.
Hold our position.
What do you say, Hanson?
All right. Come on, hurry.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me?
get him out.
How do you feel?
All right.
That's it. That's everything that was in there. A watch. A lousy watch.
Petty theft. Hardly up to your standard, Danzig.
I take what other people are too weak to keep. Whether it's 3 days deck privileges, your ship, or a cheap watch.
What a treasure.
One fifth of nothing.
Find anything?
Nothing. Not one thing.
Let me see. They put into port once at Pelangbang Point.
But no mention of Peter, not one word, nothing.
Got word of the hurricane and rushed towards Krakatoa. But what was he doing at Pelangbang?
Chris, I can't take it anymore. I don't know why I let you put me through any of this. It's hopeless.
Not hopeless. At least we know now where the ship stopped last. We might find something more.
Is about to go. I suggest we do the same.
I miss you very much. I'm going to a new school.
Yes, that's Pelham. There's a mission.
That's what it says right here. I miss you very much, and I hope you can come and visit me. I love you. Oh, Chris!
He's there. I'm sure he's there. Did you say Pelangbang?
Yes.
That's where we're going.
Everybody under cover.
Yes, sir.
Deck's cleared.
Shall I set up a fire watch?
Yes. Juan?
Yes, sir.
Keep an eye on starboard.
Aye, aye, sir.
I wonder what Pennant Bank is going to look like.
We'll know in a minute. Keep her dead slow.
Thank you.
Come along, starboard.
Aye, aye, sir.
Stop the engines.
You need help.
No help. Hurry. Go.
The people from the mission, where are they?
Take other boat. All gone.
And the children from the school?
All the same. Gone this morning.
Where?
Java.
What kind of boat? What kind of boat?
Hold 665.
Aye, aye, sir.
Java.
Spotter on the starboard turned around to meet her. Looks like to be in trouble.
Is it?
Too far to tell. They're in trouble. Lower the lifeboat. Get the ladder over the side. Break out the diving platform. Starboard bar.
It's already slowly sinking since we first sighted.
Sailors, get the children. Get the children first.
diving platform over the side. The children first. The children first.
Give me a hand.
Someone get a blanket,
please.
Keep
it dry.
Ah, gentlemen, you found them. Congratulations, Peter. Take the chest below, so we can see what you have brought us. Mr. Kwan.
Yes, sir.
Get our passengers from the sampan below deck and under shelter, then rig for storm.
Thank you.
Mr. Connolly, perhaps we could wait for Captain Hanson. He'll be here in a moment.
He'll get his share, whether he's here or not.
The pearls won't melt, Mr. Connolly. We have time, don't we?
Mr. Connolly's a man of the sea. He knows better.
What does he know?
About the tidal wave.
Tsunami!
The one Captain Hanson is preparing for.
Get some cushions. Hurry, more open. Blankets. Hurry up there, hurry up. The lamps. Take them off. Come.
Chris.
Don't worry. We'll be ready for it.
Harry, after all this, will we make it?
We have a chance, a very good chance, if we get to deep water.
Deep water? We're almost to Anger, for God's sake.
The wave will crush Anger, but we might ride it out at sea.
You go to sea. Put us ashore.
Oh, Mr. Connolly, you have been sailing long enough to know perfectly well it's impossible to get in and out of Anger fast enough to save the ship.
What's happening?
I think our chances are better on the ship.
Hurry up!
What about the lifeboat, Captain Hanson?
Lifeboat won't be of any use.
Give it to us anyway.
What for? To go to Anger? You're out of your mind.
Well, I'm not going to ride out a tidal wave in this rust bucket with you in command, I'll tell you that.
Mr. Connolly, you have been a troublemaker from the very first moment.
I should be glad that you are leaving my ship. But as a captain, I feel it's my duty to point out to you that if you're going to Anger, you're going to die.
We too choose land, Captain.
But the wave will wipe you out! Don't you realize that?
That's our choice.
Here's your share. You have less than 20 minutes. You'd better hurry. I'll be back. Come with me.
Anybody else ready?
We are.
Come on. Hey, Charlie. Charlie, come on. Come on. It's all right.
Charlie, come on, show.
Papa.
Mother.
I'm not going.
Leoncavallo. Leoncavallo, you must come with me.
Papa, I don't want to die with you. No, I want us to live together. I'm not going.
Listen, since you were a little fellow, a handsome, intelligent, stubborn little fellow, I hope something would happen. A word, a gesture that would bind us together for the rest of our lives. And now that we have found
it... And I'm still stubborn. And I want to live as much as you do.
Then we must go ashore.
But there won't be any shore. Papa, don't you understand? It'll be under 100 feet of water.
The boat will go like a matchstick.
And a matchstick floats, Papa.
Yes, but... Oh, Mamma Mia. We always are.
Trust me. Please, just once, trust me.
Yeah. Well, maybe it won't be as bad as Captain Hanson says. Either on the ship or at Anger. Goodbye.
Papa.
Huh?
I...
Goodbye. Grazie, Capitano.
Peter. This should be very exciting for you now. We are going to have a great adventure. Will you be up to it? You're a big boy. You'll be brave, promise. All right, come. Sit down. Yeah, you can do it, huh? I knew you can do it. All right, all right. You win. Goose Point Lighthouse, Andrew and us. What is it, Shaw?
Oh, about 10 fathoms.
That's not enough. Is there any muscle left in those engines?
I'll find out.
Could everything ship shape?
What's the pressure reading?
120 pounds, sir.
Open it up.
Blow the whistle before we take the wave.
Harry, we'll give you a whistle before we take the wave.
help you below.
See the ship?